Hello dear friends, welcome back to my channel. I am Dr. Megha Soni. Today we are going to learn a very basic topic, that is neuron. But it is very important to know because the whole nervous system is made up of neuron. Now what is neuron? Neuron is a basic cell. Okay, you know our body is made up of cell. More than one cell are forming the tissues and more than one tissues form the organs and more than one organ forms the system. So basically our whole body is made up of neuron. So neuron is a cell which form the whole nervous system. You know the nervous system is divided into two parts, the central nervous system and the peripheral nervous system. The central nervous system consists of brain and spinal cord, and the peripheral nervous system consists of somatic system, nerve system and a autonomic nervous system. So this all system are made up of neuron. So this definition of neuron is very simple. Neuron is a structural and the functional unit of nervous system. It is just like a cell, the other parts of the cell. But there are few differences between this cell and the cells of the other part. Mainly two differences are there. First, the neuron, the structure of neuron. Can you see? This is the structure of neuron. So the structure of neuron is quietly different from the other cells of the body, other parts of the body. Why? Because this cell body is irregular in shape. Second, this cell body is having nucleus, but basically the cell of the other parts are having a centrosome. What is the function of centrosome? Centrosome is mainly responsible for the division of the cell, but this neuron does not have centrosome near the nuclei. So this neuron cannot divide because it does not have centrosome. So these are the mainly two basic difference between the neuron and the cells of the other parts of the body. Okay, so now we quickly see the structure of neuron. So the neuron is consist of mainly three structure: dendrites, cell body and axon. Okay, it has three structure: dendrites, axon and the cell body. So can you see this is irregular structure. So this one is cell body. Okay, from the cell body many processes are arising. So this short processes green in color, this all short processes are called as dendrites, and the one long process which arises from the cell body, so this one process is called as axon. Okay, so cell body have many organelles just like the other cells of our body. So it has nucleus, this is nucleus, the red one is nuclei. Okay, it is filled up with some fluid that is called as cytoplasm, but the fluid is situated inside the neuron, so this fluid is called as neuroplasm. In fluid there are many other organelles, like this spotted like of structure is called as nasal body. Okay, then thread like this structure is neurofilament, this structure is called as Golgi. So many organelles are situated in cell body, but the nasal granules are only situated in cell body and the dendrites. You can see the spotted red structure. This is only situated inside the cell body and dendrites. But these nasal granules are not situated inside the axon. That is why when you stain this neuron and when you see this structure under the microscope, you can easily distinguish between the axon and the cell body and the dendrites of the neuron. Fine. Now, first we'll see the function of this neuron and what is the difference between dendrites and the axon. So, neuron has many dendrites. Neuron may have dendrites or may not have dendrites. But if the cell body has dendrite, it is always more than one and they are short in length. But neuron has only one axon which is long in length. So this is the basic difference between dendrite and the axon, that dendrites are short and they are many in numbers, and axon is long in length but they are only one in number. Now the second difference is this dendrite actually increases the surface area of cell body. Can you see? It is originated from the end of the cell body. So actually it increases the area of the cell body. Now what is the function of dendrites? So this cell body and the dendrites, they are connected with the another neurons of surrounding. Okay, so there are many neurons situated surrounding the surrounding this dendrite and the cell body. So these neurons are basically directly attached with the dendrite and the cell body. They are directly attached with the dendrite and the cell body. Now what is the function of this dendrite? Actually these dendrites act as a receptor. What is the function of receptor? Receptor always receives the sensation from the periphery. As this dendrites act as a receptor, they also receive sensation from the peripheral. Peripheral means, as I said, these dendrites are directly attached with the neuron. So this dendrite receives the electrical signal from the surrounding neuron. Okay, it receives the electrical signal from the peripheral. As this is also attached with the cell body, so some signal are also directly going to the cell body. Okay. So this it receives the signal, and this signal are called as electrical signal action potential. Okay. So now this dendrite actually receives the sensation from periphery to the central part, that is peripheral to the cell body. Now this action potential will travel from dendrite to the cell body. Okay, now what is the function of axon? Axon act as an effector. What do you mean by effector? Effector means it gives effect to the another neuron. Okay, it gives effect to the neuron which is directly attached with the axon. So mainly the function of axon is it carries the sensation away from the cell body. As this axon is attached with the this axon is attached with the another neuron. It is directly attached with the another neuron. So what axon will do? It receives the sensation from the cell body. It carries the sensation away from the cell body, and it gives sensation to the another neuron or a muscle which is directly attached with the axonal end. Clear with this? So the basic difference between dendrite and axon is the dendrites are acting as a receptor and this axon act as a effector. Dendrites receives the sensation from the peripheral to the central, and the axon carries the sensation from central part to the periphery. And the second difference is they are shorting process and this axon is longing process. So clear with the basic idea of neuron. Okay, now we'll see the dendrite. Okay, we have seen that the dendrites are branch and process neuron. It has a mesial granules and the neurofibrils shorter than the axon, and it transmit the impulses towards the cell body. Fine. So this is all about the dendrites. Now we'll see the cell body. So cell body contain a fluid that is called as neuroplasm, and in neuroplasm there are many organelles. So in neuron, mainly cell body consists of nucleus, nasal body, neurofibril, mitochondria and the Golgi apparatus. Now what is nucleus? This black round portion is nucleus. So each and every cell body has nucleus, and in nucleus there are one or two nucleoli. This red part is nucleoli. Okay, but this nuclei consists of the centrosome, and which is responsible for the division of the cell. But the neuron does not contain, or this nuclei does not contain centrosome. That is why the cell body or the cell body of neuron cannot divide. Fine. So this is all about the cell nuclei of the cell body of neuron. Second is mesial body. Okay. So as I said, the nasal body are situated in cell body. Nasal bodies are situated in cell body and a in a dendrite, but basal bodies are not situated in axons. This cortex structure is nasal body. Now, what is the function of nasal body? Nasal body mainly consists of ribosome. Nasal body consists of ribosome. And what is the function of ribosome? Ribosome is responsible for synthesis of protein, and that protein is actually important for the survival of this cell. As this nasal body is only situated in dendrite and the cell body, but it is not situated in axon. So through the axonal flow, this synthesized protein will be transmitted from cell body to the axon. So by this way, the axon also get protein from the dendrites and the cell body. So this is all about the nasal body. The third structure is neurofibril. Neurofibril is situated in cell body as well as the axon. The neurofibrils are thread-like structure. Can you see this blue one? Okay, so this blue one are the neurofibrils, thread-like structure, which is situated in cell body, dendrite as well as in axon. Now, this neurofibrils consist of microtubule and the microfilament. Now, what is microfilament? Microfilament actually a one type of protein. It is made up of actin, and actin is protein. So microfilament and the microtubule are mainly responsible to maintain the structure of cell, okay, as well as it also responsible for the movement of organelles inside the cell body. Okay, so these are the mainly two functions of microfilament and the microtubule. It maintains the structure of the cell and it is responsible for the movement of organelle or a transmission of important structure inside the or important socket. So this microfilament and microtubule are mainly responsible to maintain the cell structure, and they are also responsible for the transmission of important substance inside the cell body. Clear with this? Now, mitochondria. All of you know the function of mitochondria, okay? Mitochondria is a powerhouse, okay? It is actually producing the ATP, and ATP is very important for the transmission of action potential from one structure of neuron to the another structure of neuron. So it is situated in cell body. And the last one is Golgi apparatus, this green one. This green one portion is Golgi apparatus. Now, what is the function of Golgi apparatus? Golgi apparatus is actually responsible for packaging and the delivery of the protein. Okay, so it act as a shipping department of the cell body. Why? Because it is responsible for the packaging of protein and the delivering of the protein from one structure of neuron to the another structure of neuron. That is why it is called as a shipping department of the cell body. So this is all about the organelles of cell body. Again, the cell body consists of nucleus, nasal body, neurofibril, mitochondria and the Golgi apparatus. So we have seen dendrites and the cell body. Now we see the important topic of neuron, that is the axon, which is actually responsible for the transmission of the action potential from one structure to the another structure. Now, before going to that, I would like to tell you the meaning of another terminology, that is neurites. What is neurite? Actually, neurite is also a neuron, but neurite is a process of the neuron. So you know the neuron has two types of process, dendrite and the axon. So the dendrite and the axon together are called as neurites. Okay, but the dendrite, cell body and axon, they are called as neuron. So simple, neurites also a neuron, but it consists of only the processes like a dendrites and the axon. Now this neuron is mainly responsible for the white matter and the gray matter of the nervous system. You know the whole nervous system is made up of white matter and the gray matter. So this axon and the dendrites are mainly from the white matter. and this neuron, the cell body, of the neuron mainly form the gray matter. As this axon is surrounded by the myelin sheath and it is white in color, that is why the matter is called as a white matter. Clear with this? Now we'll see the important structure of the neuron, that is axon. Axon is actually a nerve fiber. It forms the peripheral system of our body. So we'll see the structure of axon. Can you see in this diagram? This is a basic structure of neuron that we have seen. These are dendrite, cell body. The another name of cell body is called as soma. And this one is axon. So actually axon arises from the one part of the cell body. So the place from which this axon arises is called as axon hillock. So this part is called as axon hillock. This whole long process is called as axon. Fine. There is a fluid inside the axon. That fluid is called as exoplasm. The fluid which is situated inside the cell body or soma is called as neuroplasm or cytoplasm. And the fluid which is situated inside the axon is called as exoplasm. Now, this axon is surrounded by the myelin sheath. Can you see this red one, myelin sheath? Okay, but this myelin sheath is not continuous in nature. It is absent at certain interval. You can see this myelin sheath is absent at a certain interval. So this absent portion is called as node of Ranvier or an internode region of the axon. And this myelin sheath is surrounded by one layer, membranous layer, that is called as neurolemma. So this blue layer, which surrounds the myelin sheath is called as neurolemma. So we'll see the in detail structure of axon. Now, as I said, the axon is actually a nerve fiber. So first we'll see the structure of nerve fiber. When you cut the nerve fiber, what type of structure you can see, what type of internal structure you will see in axon. So this is the nerve fiber. Okay, we'll see from here to here. So this is one nerve fiber. So this one nerve fiber is surrounded by a one membranous layer that is called as endoneura. Can you see the green line? The one green line means one nerve fiber. And this one nerve fiber is surrounded by the one membranous layer that is called as endoneura, which is the innermost layer of the nerve fiber. Now, many nerve fibers are coming together and form a bundle of nerve fiber. So, these are many nerve fibers. The green lines are many nerve fibers and they form the bundle of nerve fibers. Okay. So, this bundle of nerve fiber is surrounded by again one membranous layer, this red one. Okay, these are the bundle of nerve fibers and this bundle of nerve fibers are surrounded by this red layer, membranous layer. So, this red layer is called as perineum, which is the which surrounds the bundle of nerve fiber. Now, there are many bundle of nerve fibers. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So, this all bundle of nerve fibers are called as fasciculi. These are called as fasciculi. What is fasciculi? Fasciculi are a bunch of number, bundle of nerve fibers. So, this nerve fibers are coming together and they all are surrounded by one layer that is called as apineurum. So apineurum is the most outer covering layer of the nerve. Perineurum is situated at its middle part and the endoneurum is the innermost layer of the nerve fiber. You can also see here, this is the most blue outer covering layer, that is the apineurum. These are fasciculi, bundle of nerve fibers. More than one bundle of nerve fibers are coming together. That they are called as fasciculi and they are surrounded by again a membranous layer. So this red layer is called as perineurum and this black is the single nerve fiber which is surrounded by again a layer, green one, that is called as an endoneurum. So these all are the covering layer of the nerve fiber and it forms axon. Means axon forms this nerve fiber. I hope you understood the layer of nerve fibers because it is very important in nerve injury. The nerve injury, the classification of nerve injury is totally based on the layer of the nerve fibers. So you are supposed to know the layers of the nerve fibers. Now we'll see the structure of axon. Axon are of two type. Axon are of two type, myelinated and the non-myelinated. means nerve fibers are of two type, myelinated nerve fibers and the non-myelinated nerve fibers. Now what is myelinated nerve fiber? Myelinated nerve fiber means the nerve fiber is surrounded by a concentric layer of Schwann cell. Okay, that is called as myelinated, and in non-myelinated there will be no any concentric layer of Schwann cell. So first I would like to tell you about the non-myelinated nerve fiber. Can you see this? This is not, this is axon. This is axon, and this axon is surrounded by a single layer. This black, it is a membranous layer. This axon is surrounded by this single layer. So this single layer is called as a neurolemma. This single layer is called as neurolemma. Okay, and this neurolemma is made up of Schwann cell. Okay, the axon which is surrounded by a single layer, that is called as neurolemma, and this neurolemma is made up of Schwann cell, and it is continuous in nature. You can see there is no interval in this length of the covering layer. There is no interval. So this type of axon or a nerve fiber is called as non-myelinated nerve fiber. Clear? Now we'll see the myelinated nerve fiber. The myelinated nerve fiber, in that there will be internal. This is the myelinated nerve fiber. It is surrounded by the certain concentric layer, and this myelination is not continuation in nature. You can see there will be breakage in the continuity of this layer. So this breakage, this portion where the myelination is absent, is called as node of Ranvier. Okay, so this absent portion is surrounded by only a single layer of neurolemma. Okay, here only the single layer of neurolemma is situated. Fine. Now we'll see the structure of myelination. So myelination is actually a concentric layer of lipid and alternating protein. You can see this is the nerve fiber which is surrounded by the concentric layer. Okay, this green, these are the concentric layer, and this concentric layer are alternating of protein. One layer is made up of protein, and then one is made up of lipid. Again, the one layer is made up of protein. So it is the concentric layer of protein alternating the lipid. Now, this myelination is white in color. That is why it gives the appearance of white. The nerve fiber looks like a white in color. Now we'll see the myelinogenesis, how the myelin sheath forms surrounding the axon. So what is myelinogenesis? The myelinogenesis means the formation of myelin sheath over the axon. Now this myelinogenesis starts during the 4 months of intrauterine life in womb, and it is completed after the 2 years of the birth. Now what happened before 4 months of intrauterine life, there will be only one layer. Before 4 months of intrauterine life of the womb, there will be only one layer surrounding the axon, or as I can say, there will be only one layer, that is neurolemma, surround the axon. Okay, after the four months, this neurolemma starts to wrap up. As this neurolemma is made up of Schwann cell, so Schwann cell start to wrap up around the axon. This is the axon. Suppose there will be only one layer. What happened? This Schwann cell start to wrap up around the axon. Okay, and at the end of the 2 months, this all concentric layer, you can easily distinguish this layer, fine. But after the 2 years of the birth, this all layer fuse with each other and form the myelin sheath. Clear? It is very important to understand the structure of myelin sheath. So this process is called as myelinogenesis. Now, as you have seen, for myelinogenesis, neurolemma is very important. Means if there is no neurolemma, the myelin sheath cannot form. So there is one difference in nervous system, that in peripheral nervous system, neurolemma is situated. which is responsible for myelinogenesis. But in central nervous system, in brain, there is no neurolemma. It means the cells situated in brain do not have the neurolemma. But still, there are few cells which are myelinated in brain. How? Because some supporting cells are there. Neuroglia. What is neuroglia? Neuroglia are the supporting cells situated nearer to the neuron. Okay. So, oligodendrocyte. Oligodendrocyte is the one type of neuroglia or a supporting cell. So, in central nervous system, in brain, oligodendrocyte is responsible for this myelinogenesis, and in peripheral nervous system, neurolemma is responsible for the formation of the myelin sheath. Why? Because in central nervous system, neurolemma is absent. So oligodendrocyte is doing its work. I hope you clear with this structure of this myelination. Now we'll see the function of myelination. It is very important. There are mainly two functions of myelination, because myelin sheath is lipid. Myelin sheath is made up of lipid. So it does not allow the action potential to pass through it. Okay? It is resistant to electrical signal. So what happens when action potential comes from peripheral to the body and from body to the axon? This myelin sheath will not allow it to pass from it. Okay, but we have some region where the myelination is absent. You can see here, we have some portion in which the myelin sheath is absent and the neurolemma is present. Neurolemma can pass the, neurolemma allows the action potentials to pass. So when the action potential comes here, it will directly jump from one node of Ranvier to another node of Ranvier. Why? Because it cannot pass through the lipid. So here also I would like to show you, action potential jumps like this, one node of Ranvier to another node of Ranvier. Okay, so this type of conduction is called as a saltatory conduction, or else you can also call it grasshopper conduction. That is why the action potential can travel fast. Okay, because of this reason, the action potential will travel fast. Fine. In non-myelinated, what happened in non-myelinated neuron? There is no node of Ranvier. So this action potential has to travel throughout the length of the neurolemma. So in non-myelinated axon, the action potential travel very slowly. But in myelinated axon, the action potential travels very fast. So this is the basic difference between the myelinated nerve fiber and the non-myelinated nerve fiber. The second function is, this provide the insulation to the axon, because it has an insulating capacity. So these are the basic two function of myelin sheath. First, it gives the saltatory conduction, means action potential jumps from one node of Ranvier to another node of Ranvier. That is why the action potential can travel fast. And second, it provides the insulation to the axon. Okay, because it has an insulating capacity. I hope you clear with this axon, the structure of axon, the covering layer of nerve fibers, myelinated neuron, that is myelinated axon, non-myelinated axon, and the formation of the myelin sheath and the function of myelin sheath. Now we'll see the classification of neurons. So neuron is classified into three. First, depending upon number of poles. Second, depending upon the function of neuron. And third, depending upon the length of the axon. So first we'll see the depending upon number of poles. So according to number of poles, the neurons are divided into three. It is subclassified into three: unipolar neuron, bipolar neuron, and the multipolar neuron. So now what is unipolar neuron? Unipolar neuron means the cell body has only one pole from which both the processes arise. Both the processes like dendroid, dendrites, and the axon. So can you see in this diagram, this is a cell body and this cell body has a single pole which gives origin to both. These are dendrites and these are axon. Okay, so it has a single pole from which both the dendrites and the axon arise. So this type of structure of neuron is called as unipolar neuron. Now second, bipolar neuron. It is simple as that. The cell which has two poles. One pole gives origin to dendrites and one pole gives origin to axon. So this type of structure is called as a bipolar neuron. And the third, which we have seen, that is the multipolar neuron. What is multipolar neuron? The cell has more than two poles, okay, which gives origin to the many dendrites and the one axon. So you can see there are many poles of the cell body or a soma. So some this poles gives origin to many dendrites and it gives origin to one long axon. So this type of structure is called as a multipolar neuron. Now unipolar neuron type of structure is only present during the embryonic stage of the life, and this type of structure are present in central as well as the peripheral nervous system. So this is all about the first classification. Depending upon the number of pole, unipolar, bipolar and the multipolar. Now we'll see the second classification depending upon the function. Okay, so depending upon the function, it is subdivided into two, motor neuron and the sensory neuron. All of you know what is motor neuron and what is sensory neuron. We have seen this in our spinal cord chapter. The motor neuron gives origin to efferent nerve and the sensory neuron gives origin to the efferent nerve. What is the function of efferent nerve? It supplies or it sends the signal from central nervous system to the peripheral. Okay, it sends signal to central nervous system to peripheral. Peripheral like muscle, okay, tendon, ligament, joints. Okay, so it sends signal from the brain to the peripheral. So this type of neuron is called as motor neuron. And the second, sensory neuron, which gives origin to the efferent nerve. What is the function of efferent nerve? It sends signal peripheral to the central. We have seen this type of neuron in an ascending track and this type of neuron in a descending track. So this is all about the classification of neuron according to the function. Motor neuron, sensory, motor neuron efferent, sensory efferent. It sends a signal from central to the peripheral. It sends signal from peripheral to the central. And the third one is depending upon the length of the axon. So depending upon the length of the axon, it is divided into two, Golgi type 1 and the Golgi type 2. Now what is the difference between Golgi type 1 and Golgi type 2? So Golgi type 1 has one long axon. It has a long axon. Whereas the Golgi type 2 has a short axon. So this is the basic difference between the type 1 and the type 2. Okay? That is why the name has been given depending upon the length of the axon. Second, the Golgi type 1. In Golgi type 1 of neuron, the cell body is situated in a CNS and the axon are situated in a peripheral part of it. Okay? So it mainly Golgi type 1 has a long axon. The cell body of Golgi type 1 is situated centrally and the axon is situated peripherally. In Golgi type 2, it has a short axon and this type of neuron are present in cerebral cortex as well as the spinal cord. It means it is present in a central nervous system. Fine. And this type is mainly situated in peripheral nervous system, PNS. You know the PNS consists of somatic nervous system and autonomic nervous system, and central nervous system consists of brain, cerebral cortex and the spinal cord. So this is all about the classification of neuron. Again, it is divided into three, number of pole, number of function and the length. In number of pole, it is divided into three, unipolar, bipolar, multipolar. According to function, it is divided into two, motor neuron and the sensory neuron. And according to length, it is divided into two, Golgi type 1 and Golgi type 2. So this is all about the basic of neuron. Again, it is a very important chapter to know, because the whole nervous system is totally based on this chapter. Even the injuries of nerves are also depending on the structure of the axon. I hope you understood my lecture. I hope you understood my lecture. I have put my link below. You can see all my previous lecture. Thank you very much and happy learning.